How to write a persuasive sales letter? In this video, I want to give you a different perspective about this topic, and most probably, I'm going to reveal something that you don't expect. My name is Max Cecco. I have been writing sales letters since 2009, when I started learning this fantastic skill. Copy is fascinating because you have a real opportunity to learn many aspects about selling in every piece of content you will create. Before sharing this knowledge, I suggest you subscribe to my channel and turn the notification on to be notified every time I upload a new daily video. If you like this type of content, tap on the like button as well. I have already recorded a video about the fundamental aspects you have to consider when writing copy. Especially if you start from the beginning, I urge you to watch this content. I put the link in the description and probably above this video as well. For sure, I'll make another video, most probably more than one, to help you understand the main sections you need to pay attention to when you write copy. In this video, I want to focus your attention on some important aspects of copy that are always valid, no matter the topic you're writing to. First of all, do not start writing anything without acquiring the proper information. Otherwise, you will suffer the disease called writer block, and you will stare at the blinking cursor waiting for the words you need to write something interesting. Why I'm telling you this? Because it happened to me, especially at the beginning. I didn't have any clear idea of what to write, and to be very honest, I didn't understand why it was so difficult to start writing some words on a piece of paper. One of the most critical mistakes in writing copy is avoiding interviewing the owner of the product or service you are presenting. I want you to understand that before writing a single line of copy, you need to collect lots of information about these three main topics. Number one, the ideal client. Number two, product and offer creation. Number three, the story behind the product. And in this video, I want to share with you the questions related to the ideal client of your product or service. Keep in mind that if you want to sell a product or a service for another company, I highly recommend you answer all the questionnaires with the person who is responsible for the object you have to sell. Let me give you real examples. If you have to create a sales letter for a yoga course, you need to interview the author of this yoga course. If you have to create a copy for selling a service, you need to interview the person who created and provided this service. I discourage you from doing all the work by yourself. Even if you are good at finding information on the web, the author or the person who made the specific product you want to sell has knowledge and experience that you can't find online or elsewhere. Please talk to these people first. This is why I didn't start telling you how to dissect the most important steps for writing a sales letter as other YouTubers do, because it doesn't make any sense. You need to have the proper information first. I watch different videos on YouTube, and to be honest, I don't find anyone speaking about finding the correct information in order to write a good piece of copy. Once you have answered these 23 questions, you have a clear idea of what to write on a piece of paper. In addition, by answering these questions, you will develop the ability to create instant empathy with your ideal customer, because you understand every aspect of him based on the product or service you want to sell. When you have written all these answers, writing a sales letter is much easier, and you will be able to persuade your potential client to do whatever you want. This is the reason why these questions are incredibly powerful. You will be able to create sales letters, video scripts, educational video, persuasive emails, and so on. But pay attention. I want to share with you this important thing. Please, When you answer these questions, do not overthink. Just write down whatever you think is correct, even the most stupid idea. Then you can choose the proper information by revising what you have written. Do not answer with a single sentence, but write down all the thoughts you have and think of it as a brainstorming process. I want to help you understand how this process works. Let's suppose we are selling an online course on how to create a website with WordPress. Question number one, which type of potential customer do you want to attract? Describe him or her in detail. My answer. My customer wants to understand how to create a website independently. He doesn't know where to start. He doesn't know, most probably, any programming language. He doesn't want to spend tons of money to create a website. And on the flip side, he wants to understand how to modify his website without asking anything to anyone. Question number two, who is your ideal client? Define it with specificity. You need to know all this information. Man or woman? Let's suppose our ideal client is a man. Then, how old is he? Is he married? Does he have children? What's his profession? What is his annual income? What does he do on the weekends? How is his look? Does he like reading? Most probably you are asking, Max, what the why do I have to be interested in what my client does in his spare time or with his family or if he is reading something? I understand your point of view. Remember that each client we choose to serve has different needs, fears, desires and goals. Bear with me and trust the process. When you start writing a sales letter, once you have gathered all this information, it will be pretty easy and you will be able to connect all the dots. Question number three. What does your ideal customer want from a practical point of view? What does he want to accomplish? What is he looking for? My answer. My client wants a simple guide that can help him create a website with WordPress in a few hours, not days, not months. In addition, he doesn't want to invest lots of money and he wants to be able to do this website on his own. He's looking for a practical video tutorial, step by step, and in addition, he wants to be assisted if something goes wrong. He wants someone available if he has some questions about the topic or just in case he needs help. Question number four. What does your ideal client want from an emotional point of view? What would his life be like if he found what he was searching for? Keep in mind that we are selling emotions. So, for every product or service you want to sell, think about the specific emotions related to that product. In our case, since he wants to create a website, most probably he has a company, or maybe he is starting his business from scratch. Questions. What are the emotions related to a video tutorial that allows you to create a website to introduce your company? We can think of it as a sales machine. So, once you have your website ready, your clients can find you on the web. You can start selling your products and services from your new website and you can start making money. From this point of view, creating a website becomes one of the most important investments for your company. It's a one-time investment that can potentially produce an enormous amount of money. You are selling an increase of social status to your client. In addition, your client is saving money because he is willing to learn how to create a website on his own without paying thousands of dollars to a web agency. In addition, he is saving time because he didn't have to wait weeks for a web agency to create a website. Making money, saving time are all associated with emotions and are great motivators. Question number five. What is his hypnotic state? What is his internal dialogue? This is a critical question. You have to imagine how your ideal client is talking to himself based on the product or service you are offering. Let me give you an example. In our case, with the online course on how to create a website with WordPress, we can imagine an internal dialogue like this one. Oh my God, I need to create a website, but I don't know anything about coding. I don't know what to do, but for sure, I don't want to refer to a web agency. The investment for creating a website has its weight. Then they need time in order to prepare your website. I want to save money because I'm launching my new business and I absolutely need to find a solution to create this website on my own. I would really like to find a video tutorial step by step. But at the same time, I want someone to help me if I find the creation of the website too difficult. I want support. I don't want to be alone. I need to find this solution. Question number 6. What is his language regarding the topic related to your product or service? One of the most important things in persuasion is to understand the point of view of your client better than himself. By using the same words he's utilizing, you become part of his world. In our case, since we are referring to a beginner or someone who is looking for knowledge on how to create a website, we have to use easy language without any problematic words. Instead, if you are selling how to customize a website for an advanced target, you could use special words or expressions just to relate to that specific target. It's crucial. Question number 7. What is his mindset regarding the topic you are sharing? I mean, say, what are his fears? What are his biases? What are his needs? Example, will it be difficult? And what if I'm not able to do what the author teaches me? Do I need additional skills? Do I need to know the basics of coding? What about bringing visitors to the website? In other words, you need to identify possible objections that your potential clients could have regarding your product or service. Question number 8. Why is your potential client unsatisfied? How does he live this dissatisfaction daily? With this question, we are eliciting his frustrations, his problems related to the product or service you are selling. Every product or service is born to fix a specific problem our potential clients have. We provide solutions to existing problems. In our case, my client is unsatisfied because he understands how important having a website is in order to start his business. But on the flip side, he is looking for a solution based on his needs and fears. His dissatisfaction can be something like this. My competitors have a website. They are online, they are selling stuff to their clients, and I need a system to be able to sell my stuff as well. I don't know exactly what to do, who can help me, how I can do to create a website, and so on. Once you have all these answers, you can create a persuasive speech. It's like making a puzzle. You can choose the correct information based on the different pieces of your sales letter. I urge you to use the same words you utilized to answer the previous questions. You know the problems your potential client has, how he is living his life by looking for a specific solution, how he thinks about the solution he is searching for, his fears, what he really wants, and so on. Keep in mind that we didn't talk about the product, the offer, the bonuses, and other interesting things. This is the topic for the next video. If you find the information I shared valuable, or if you think this information can help other people, feel free to share the video with anyone you want. It's a pleasure for me. Do not forget to subscribe to my channel and please let me know your point of view by leaving a comment below this video. Keep in touch in the next episode.